time richer than the richest man, he would want a second. If Allah gives him the second, well, he would want a third. So based on this, sister, it is subjective. But regarding a normal question, that will IRF be able to give to the same profession outside than others? Yes. There was a time when I said we want to be A plus, the best. I'm not saying we are the best, but we are amongst the best. Surely we pay salary for the same job what it does outside on an A level. There are people who pay A plus also. So there's so much of competition, especially in the media, and the shaitan is there. So at a time I always wanted to be A plus. Now I said no, A is sufficient. So what we pay, whether to a cameraman outside, inside, whether to a director working outside, even though we are competing with multinationals. Same way with our teachers, inshallah, I cannot say we are paying the best in Bombay, but surely we are paying on the higher side to the teachers. So if a student wants to be a teacher, but natural teaching in IIS would be far better for him in this dunya than teaching outside. Fine, if you say that, can you compare his salary to a person who wants to become a doctor? Fine, if I say that if he becomes an average doctor, then our teacher's salary will be better than a, not average, a low doctor. That I can say, because we have got, mashallah. Because if our students, you fail to realize that what we pay now, what we pay to dais, the high level dais, is much more than an average doctor what he earns in Bombay. We are paying to a high dais much more than an average engineer. But if you compare to the best engineer, then but natural. You cannot pay him that much as the best engineer. So based on that, alhamdulillah, he can very well sacrifice even his medical profession in terms of money. In terms of sawab, you cannot compare. The sawab of a dai is far superior. And as we are growing, now when we go to the new section, but naturally the whole scale also keeps on changing. And as mashallah, Allah is helping us, what we are seeing, we want to give a platform in which deen and dunya is more. And what we realize that all those who have been paid hashed in our organization, they never demand. The top five in organization who are being paid, mashallah, big, not the school, are being paid more than 1 lakh rupees. None of them demanded. And I'm sure of it that even if I give them half, they will not leave the organization. But these are the pillars. These are the pillars. So what we realize, because they've got so much involved in the field of Islam, they aren't working for money. But just because they're not working for money, I cannot be unjust and say, okay, theek hai, isko aadha bhi denge to rahega, to aadha do na. So many people say, Zakir bhai, why are you giving so much? I say, because they deserve it. Not that we have extra money, because you deserve it. So if you take one step in the way of Allah, Allah will take 10 steps in your way. Deen and dunya both, alhamdulillah. So we have gone to a professional level, unlike that. It's not like you sacrifice everything, then only can you do the work of Allah. So, mashallah, yes, there are the sacrifices. So normally I feel that once we grow and we are growing, alhamdulillah. But the main thing is, I would not want them to say that because IRF is giving a good salary, therefore we want to work in IRF or IS. I want them to come for sake of Allah. So Allah gives them this din and dunya also. Because Allah says in Surah Hud and many other verses that if you do it for Akhirah, Allah will give Akhirah in this world also. If you do it for this world, Allah will give you in this world, but will not give you in Akhirah. And the best example is me. You know, mashallah, we had a lucrative business. I was 50% partner, we set up the diagnostic center. I left it, my parents gave me permission. Fine, no problem, what will we do? We'll earn less. Mashallah, we are earning much more in that business even after I left. I'm doing other business, there also we are getting mashallah. So Allah is giving. We left it thinking that we want to work for Allah. So we are working for Allah. Even if I'd been the best doctor in the world, I would not have got the respect what I get today. You know, in my dreams, I could have dreamt of becoming the best surgeon in the world. I couldn't have dreamt of speaking in front of 25 people. As you know, my mother wanted me to become like Chris Barnard, who was the first heart specialist, heart surgeon, who did the first heart transplant. So when I said, would you want me to become like Sheikh Didat or Chris Barnard? She said both. But after a few years, when I asked her the same question, she said, I can sacrifice 1,000 Chris Barnard for 1 Sheikh Didat. So what do you realize? That we did for Allah's sake. Well, not knowing that I would be a speaker, we set up IRF, I never knew I would be a speaker. But Allah gave it to us. Now the respect that I get, even the best doctor in the world won't get. We didn't do it for that. The heads of states, the kings, the sheikhs, the prime minister, the president, we are guests. We cannot imagine what respect we get. We didn't do it for that. We did for Allah, but Allah gives you But one thing is that the shaitan is always after you, the devil. You should not let the devil get the better of you. So as a dai, you should know the shaitan tempts you. You know, the power, the fame, the money, all these are distractions. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may He keep us on the straight path. For we are human beings. With that in mind, if a student of IIS does it only for the sake of Allah, inshallah Allah will give you this dunya and the akhirah. But irrespective you get this dunya or not, my logic is this dunya is for how many years? On average 60 years? Some die at the age of 20, some 40, some 60, some 80, some 100. Average 60, 55, 60. If you compare as a businessman to the next world, which is eternal, it's a very good bargain. So my logic is that take it for granted that you're doing only for akhirah. And a dai should make his requirements less. The sister asked a good question, that will it be sufficient? What is the meaning of sufficient? Therefore, when I married my wife, I told her that I will give you only 4,000 rupees per month. Minimum, not only, minimum 4,000 rupees a month. Don't marry me because I'm a doctor. Don't marry me because I'm rich. And mashallah, she was earning more than that. You know, she was teaching in a college. I give her more than 4,000. But the thing is that I told her, because you should realize that how you lead your life. Therefore, I tell my children, Allah has given the best of this world, but I make my children used to sleep on the floor. They have been to the best of hotels, 5-star hotels, 7-star hotels, deluxe hotels, and they have slept on the floor also. Because they should not get addicted or should not get dependent on this luxury. A dai can only be successful if he's not dependent on the luxury. He's not dependent on the facility. We are giving AC not for luxury, we are giving AC so that your output is better. But in the house, we have a restriction. You can't put the AC on maximum once a month or twice a month. Not that we want to save the electricity. I don't want my children to become dependent on the AC. I don't want the children that when they go, they should have the best of hotels. Fine, they have traveled, so they don't crave for that. But they have slept in the worst of the hotels. So a dai should know that these things of life, if he become dependent on, okay, today fine, I'm earning a crore rupees. Tomorrow, if my business goes down, then I leave dawa. So I make myself that fine, I can lead a life even with few thousand rupees. So when a dai knows that to make his life revolve around small facilities, if he's not dependent on luxury. That is the reason if you heard my lecture on purpose of life. And the position Allah has given us, which we don't deserve, with the amount of gifts we get, lakhs of rupees of watches, Rolex watch, Omega watch, best of watches. But if I'm dependent on this watch, if people don't recognize me because of this watch, what is the value of me? So we wear a 14 rupees watch. Many of you may be wearing more expensive watch than me also. Therefore, what we don't make them, we get pens which are costing 20,000, 30,000, one ball pen. We give gifts to others, that's what the Prophet did. I never give expensive gifts to my children. Fine, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 25 rupees, theek hai. But why should I give my son a pen when I use a pen of less than 100 rupees? Why should I give my son a pen which is 20,000 or 40,000? Why should I give my son a watch which is dependent on? He should not be recognized because he's wearing a Rolex watch. He should be recognized because of the work he does. So when you lead a life, your requirements for life should be the least. A dai will be successful if you want. I want to live in a big house. I want a house which should be 4-bedroom. Should be 2,000 square. Should I waste it then? If you don't run, you start telling lies. You start taking bribes. You start deviating from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or you may be honest, but you leave dawah and then you start earning money in the other ways. So if you make your requirements less, then what I require only 10,000 rupees to live. Then whether I ask, give me 20,000 or 30,000, what's the problem?
Allah ala sayyidina Muhammad wa Zain, Pika, and now Wong's Biali.
Hey kids, time is very precious.
This life is a gift from Allah.
Utilize this gift for here and hereafter.
Enjoy this gift in the light of the Quran and Hadith.
Enjoy Islam with us, Zain and Dawood.
Enjoying Islam with Zain and Dawood. Every Monday at 7:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 10:30 a.m. India on Peace TV. Osama El Shami.
How can we get our children ready for the month of Ramadan?
Sharing the stories of what the Muslims have been through in the past, in particular the first generation.
Nazir Irfan Al Mujahid.
Make this Ramadan very special to them.
Your taqwa, your righteousness, your goodness.
I want you to tell me about your experiences from the very first Ramadan that you experienced as a new Muslim.
The first Ramadan I experienced was amazing.
Umar Debua.
When I embraced Islam, it was like I was prepared. You know, Allah prepared me for something that I had no idea. It was an amazing experience.
Beautiful. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to our program, The Straight Path.
Build your character on the path of the Quran and Sunnah in The Straight Path. Tomorrow at 3 p.m. and repeat telecast at 1 a.m. India on Peace TV.
See, in our organization, we have helpers earning 4,000 rupees, yet they're leading a life. We have got people who earn 2 lakh rupees in an organization per month, yet they're leading a life. The person who's 4,000 rupees, arre mujhe 10,000 milenge and all my problems will be solved. The person who's 10,000, he says, I want 20,000. The person who wants 2 lakhs would want more if I take his interview. So we have people in organization earning 2 lakh rupees a month. But the problem is that you should be satisfied with what you have. What you should say, I require 10,000, whatever else I want to give it to Allah. So it doesn't make a difference whether you want 20 or 30. So if you lead your life, what I do, I have a system. Whatever I earn, minimum so much percentage goes in the way of Allah. Minimum. And yet we have so much left with us, then we give more. So if you're not dependent on it, if you're not dependent on luxury, then you should make your requirements the minimum. And believe me, now my requirements have gone up because of Peace TV. Wallah. Because of Peace TV, now I should wear different clothes. First I had few pairs. But now I'm wearing more clothes because for sake of Allah that I'm going on the channel. Never did we have only 2 suits. Now we have more suits. Why? Not because I want to look handsome. Because I convince myself Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now my personal expenses have gone up only because of this. But that is going in the way of Allah. Fine, I can take from the Peace TV budget, but why should I when Allah has given me? So what is required for the sake of Allah? So if you make your requirements less, that fine, I will lead my life in this. Whatever I earn, fine, I will invest some money. I'll give 25%, 50% of money for the sake of Allah. So if you make that, then you will never be dependent on what money you get from your work you're doing. And even now, suppose God forbid, and I tell Allah, I always pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let me not earn a single rupee more. If I earn this money which will take me away from Allah, I better not earn that money. So give me that much money as you want give. But don't give me a rupee more which will take me even 0.1% away from Allah. This is the dua that I do. Tomorrow, God forbid, something happens to me, God forbid, Allah forbid, if I don't earn money, I'll prefer taking salary from IRS. Taking salary is not haram. And if I'm worth X amount, I'll take 0.1X. I know outside people have offered job. So what I'll do, instead of one day, I'll give 10 days for sake of Allah, for my business, because I'm not earning. No. What I'll say, forget that one day also. I'll give that for sake of Allah, and I'll take about maybe, surely less than the highest person being paid here. So this, if you have your requirements cut down, then no one, inshallah, will be able to blackmail you. No one will be able to force you to do something against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with this, if your requirements are reduced to the lowest, to the minimum, that doesn't mean that you should lead a life and sleep on the floor. Please, I'm not saying that. Depending on your ability that you have, your requirement should be subdued. So what you earn, you're not dependent on that. You said, okay, fine, yet I can sacrifice 50% of what I earn. So the salary system is subjective. But compared to the outside world, for the same profession, we have a policy of paying more. But I don't want the students to join IIS because they're being paid more. I want them to join, we'll give you more. But give majority of your earnings to the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, Allah will make you on a higher standard outside and in this world, inshallah. I think inshallah we'll just have one last question.
Just one last question. That alhamdulillah we have brought up our children in a complete Islamic environment. This is for those students who will be leaving. Possibly they might have a talent to become a doctor or an engineer, which the school is not providing. So won't they be facing something like a culture shock? But I want you to give them some kind of motivational talk that they can cope up with that culture shock. As you know, when they go out in the college world, they will definitely see something which they have not been accustomed.
This has a question that there may be some students who may have the ability to become a doctor and engineer and they may leave the school. So the culture shock. Before I answer that question, sister, that doesn't mean a person who becomes a dai doesn't have the ability to become a doctor and engineer. I would want the students who have the ability to become a doctor and engineer to become a dai. Because normally what we have in society, the person who fails in school, okay, go to madrasa, become Hafiz al-Quran. What I want the best of the students to present the deen. So if a person like me who could become a doctor, I haven't left medicine because my practice did not survive. So what I want, sister, your question should have been, those who feel dawah is not important and have chosen medicine, that's a better question. Because they fail to realize that doesn't mean that a person who chooses to do dawah cannot become a doctor. He can become a doctor and a dai, but he chose to become a dai and he sacrificed the worldly glory for sake of Allah. So coming back to it, I always say that amongst the students that pass, the best 50% would take up dawah, Islamic studies, teaching. The less 50% would become doctors and engineers. Same to say that all our students should be good. But coming back to your question, if you rephrase it, that those students who yet feel that becoming a doctor is important, and if they go outside and they join a college, etc., won't there be a cultural shock? They will be. But it will not be a big shock. Why? Because they're exposing our children to the outside world also. They have educational excursion. Fine. Now, how to deal? But naturally, there should be sessions. What we have to do, that they know the theory, but they may not know the practical aspect. I'll give you one example. I can give many, time is short. For example, it is common that when a girl wants to shake hands with the gent, 99% the hand goes on top, front. I know many people who are Islamic scholars, who are dais, who know in theory shaking hands with a non-mahram girl is haram. Not that they want to, but the moment the hand comes up, your hand goes in. And I've told that to many people. Unless you're mentally prepared that if a lady puts a hand in front, how will you react? So if you're mentally prepared, you're safe. And because I keep on traveling throughout the world and mentally I'm prepared, and we know these situations come. We give talks to foreigners. We have gone to American embassies and given talks. MashaAllah, people have accepted Islam. In 2000, before 9/11, the first Muslim who gave a talk in the American embassy in Saudi Arabia was MashaAllah myself. And amongst them, there was a culture attached to accepted Islam. Oh, Dr. Naik, very good lecture. Normal, the hand will go on top. Because I'm mentally trained that, okay, what to do now? No, usko bura lagna nahi chahiye, theek hai, nahi lagna chahiye. But you know, how to reply that, sorry, ma'am, or sorry, sister, it's not all Islam. And then quote the Bible, Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse number 5, or 1 Timothy. So if you're trained, you don't make the person feel bad. Now the interview is going on. BBC this, that, some ladies, CNN, hand goes on front. So my colleague, I won't take his name, Zakir bhai, tum sach bolte hain, automatic haath aage jata hai, you know? Automatic haath aage jata hai. But because you're trained, so if you're mentally prepared what to do, otherwise you know theoretically not to shake hand. But when you go in the outside world, a foreigner, a white lady puts that, so you feel, aray, bura lage, so automatically it's human nature. But when you're trained in that way, that okay, someone says, sister, don't feel bad, one Islam, you know, this is there, then quote the Bible, oh, yes, sir. So they ask you one more question. Fine, we're lowering your gaze. So how to be trained like Maqbool? Maqbool, mashallah, you're not an Islamic scholar per se, but the way he practices Islam is one of the best in the full organization, about 400 people. The gent that follows Islam best, according to me, is mashallah Maqbool. Because not that he has gone to the research department. He's an operation manager. But the way he speaks with ladies, the way he lowers the gaze, the way he interacts. So one thing is being, because not that I told him. He sees me and he has adopted that. Other people also know. So what happens if many Islamic scholars, they talk something, but in practical life. So unless you're mentally, not that these scholars want to shake hands, don't get me wrong. But this is human nature, that's a reaction. So in this way, sister, when they go, there'll be a cultural shock. I know that. It's common. Me had a different nature, mashallah, from school itself. Allah help me. That being in a medical atmosphere, in a medical college, it is one of the worst atmosphere. So these students, they'll have to give certain tips. like how our life is outside. They know the theory, but practically, how to give them examples, how they get practically, they should be trained, and then we have that. They'll be in a better position to face the outside world, but they know the theory part of it, but practically, not that everyone who has been trained will be able to execute it. But we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. And believe me, with the position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, we meet a variety of people, top people. To refuse top people is more difficult. To refuse the layman is easy, you know. When I mean top people, are meeting heads of states, ladies on top positions in governments. So that's the reason, if you're mentally prepared and you're sure of yourself, inshallah, whatever post the opposite person is on, maybe he's the president or the prime minister or whatever it is, you know your Islam well and are mentally prepared, inshallah, you'll be on the straight path. But practically something else than theory, but inshallah, I do agree with you, there should be a session. I mean, we can't do it now, we're running short of time. But there should be a session where the people are trained, not only outsiders, even our students. I want to go a step further. Because they have an environment which is protected here. Outside, I would not like my son to go in a building which is 100% Muslim. They are Muslim, but many are far away from Islam in the society. So how to interact? So that's the reason when the teachers take them outside, when we go on excursion tour, like we have a policy in our staff that once a year we go for ATC, annual training camp, but the people have given a different acronym. There's annual torture camp, they say. And there they see me laughing, enjoying, swimming, football, everything. In Islam, doesn't mean that you don't have to enjoy life. I enjoy life, and they see me so jovial. And mashallah, same time praying tahajjud. Ha, many people say it's the first time in my life I've prayed tahajjud. You're enjoying life, you're swimming, everything halal, leaving the haram part, and yet enjoying life so much. And I've enjoyed life even in my school days, my college days, mashallah, leaving aside the evil things. We have enjoyed life. Islamic doesn't mean no enjoyment, no laughing, nothing. You can enjoy life in the halal way, and yet, mashallah, get the best of this world and the akhirah. So the answer is the last question. We are running short of time. Inshallah, we may have maybe some other time in the session. Waqir da'wana alhamdu rabbil alameen.
Up in a cell away from his family, is there a father in this world who would not defend justice and rights till the very end? We're all your jobs, baby.